The Wasatch Mountains in northern Utah are famous for having the greatest snow on Earth. Every year, tourists bring billions to the state while accessing world-class skiing. The mountain snowpack is also a critical natural resource. It provides 80% of surface water for the rapidly growing populations along the Wasatch Front, including Salt Lake City. So for the economy and for natural resources, it's crucial to understand what controls the timing and magnitude of snowmelt from the Wasatch Mountains. Many think that it's warming air temperatures in the spring that melt snow. It's actually the longer days and the sun's energy. Anything that darkens the snow surface can have a powerful effect on accelerating melting. It's the same concept as wearing a white or black shirt on a sunny day. You'll be warmer in the black shirt because it absorbs more sunlight. We know that in the nearby southern Colorado Rockies, dust deposition is so extreme that it advances snowmelt by a month on average and up to 2 months in the most dusty years. We know dust gets deposited in the Wasatch, but we don't yet know the impact on the snowpack and snowmelt rates. So, in 2017, we started paying closer attention to the dust. At an alpine site high in the Wasatch Mountains, our team at the University of Utah put instrumentation to measure dust in the air, and we regularly sampled the snow for dust concentrations. One event in particular stood out for two reasons. It deposited the most dust, and while most of our big dust events come from the south, this one came from the west, potentially from the dry lake bed of the Great Salt Lake. With more people settling in the Salt Lake Valley, the Great Salt Lake has declined as more people use water upstream. As water levels drop, more of the lake bed gets exposed. When wind speeds are high enough, the exposed dust can blow into the Salt Lake Valley and deposit onto the Wasatch snowpack. We analyzed the amount of dust that got deposited in the snowpack at our study site. We used an atmospheric model that represents the weather before, during, and after the dust event to trace where the dust particles were coming from. We found that for this single storm, dust likely came first from the south, and then as the storm front moved, the winds shifted and blew in from the west. And, as we had hypothesized, the dry lake bed of the Great Salt Lake. To figure out what impact that dust had on snowmelt, we used the amount of dust in the snowpack to calculate how much additional sunlight the dust would absorb relative to a dust-free snowpack. We found that from this one event, dust accelerated snowmelt by 5 days. And that dust from all events accelerated snowmelt by 25%. We know from the atmospheric modeling that the dust from the dry lake bed impacted the northern Wasatch more than where we were looking at dust. The Salt Lake Valley's growing populations and planned infrastructure projects will reduce the water flowing into the lake, and the lack of protections for the Great Salt Lake point toward dust emissions getting more frequent in the future. Our results indicate that we need to pay closer attention to dust source regions and dust on snow.